As many as 13 children have tested COVID-19 positive in Karnataka's Udupi. The children are between the ages of 1 to 10. The health officials were carrying out a vaccine drive and they found these children positive for COVID. Around 36 people were tested positive. The children were undergoing treatment at the health center. Petrol prices in Thane and Navi Mumbai have already crossed the rupees 100 mark. Diesel price is also at a record high of over rupees 91 per litre. On Thursday, petrol price in Mumbai was just 6 paise short of hitting a century. Diesel stood at rupees 91.87 per litre. The highest price of petrol in the state was in Parbhani, where 1 litre of petrol costs over rupees 100. Delhi will begin unlocking gradually from Monday thanks to the efforts of the 2 crore people of the city, which helped bring under control the second COVID-19 wave, said Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal. Today there was a meeting with the Disaster Management Authority. To avoid losing the advantage gained in the past month, everyone is of the opinion that the opening must be slow. There has to be some balance, he said. Beginning Monday, productive units will be allowed to function in industrial areas with confines or manufacturing premises. In specified compounds, workers will be allowed to carry out construction activities. Japan will extend a coronavirus state of emergency in Tokyo and other areas on Friday until just a month before the Olympics, in a move that is likely to fuel concerns over whether the games can be held safely. Tokyo and 9 other parts of the country are currently under emergency orders, which mostly involve closing bars and restaurants early and banning them from selling alcohol. The emergency was supposed to expire at the end of May in most places, but the government now says it needs more time to control a fourth wave of infections. Rahul Gandhi, in one of his sharpest attacks on the government's handling of COVID and the deadly second surge, said today that Prime Minister Narendra Modi was responsible for the second wave, that he did not understand COVID at all. The Congress leader also predicted multiple waves in the country if vaccinations continued at the current pace. Soon after, the government hit back and declared that vaccinations would be completed before December this year. Renowned educationist, founder of Alameen Movement and ex-pro-chancellor of Aligarh Muslim University, Dr. Mumtaz Ahmad Khan passed away on Thursday evening at Bengaluru. Dr. Mumtaz Ahmad Khan was an Indian humanitarian, educationist and social reformer. In 1966, Khan founded the Alameen Movement. The Alameen Movement is currently running 250-plus educational institutions with more than 2.5 lakh students across the country. Dr. Mumtaz Ahmad Khan was laid to rest today.